So, I was working on my next actual project, but then I thought, you know, if the Kingdom Hearts characters lived in this hypothetical, awful, crapsack universe where there's, like, a deadly, unprecedented pandemic, how would each of the characters react and handle that situation? Just out of curiosity, totally random, hypothetical situation. And luckily, I was able to get into contact with some of my top people, and they were able to do the computations and all of the calculations to figure out exactly how each person in the Kingdom Hearts universe would react to a hypothetical deadly pandemic. So let's take a look, shall we? Sora, Riku, and Kairi are doing everything they're supposed to be doing, wearing masks, washing their hands, and socially distancing. They understand that no matter where they are, they're always with their friends, in their hearts, or some junk like that. Goofy was telling everyone that this whole thing was gonna pop off back in January. Donald privately thinks all of these precautions are a bit much, but isn't going to say anything because he knows his friends will tear him to shreds over it. Mickey is an Americentric little rat who spent the last few months saying that this whole thing would blow over once the election was over, shockingly has nothing to say now that the election was nearly a month ago and things are still bad. The Queen of Hearts was denied service at an Olive Garden for not wearing a mask, tried shoulder checking her way through the locked glass door, actually managed to break through to the other side, but fell flat on her face, exposing her entire ass to the restaurant patrons and having to pay for the damages. Everyone clapped when the cops showed up to arrest her. Yen Sid got the virus but survived because he's an indestructible beefcake, subject of several articles titled things like 4,000-year-old wizard contracts virus and miraculously recovers, which is subsequently reposted several times on our uplifting news. Fu, Rai, and Cypher think masks are a sign of weakness, definitely listen to certain podcasts, it's just the flu, bro. Chernabog created the virus, I mean, he's a big bad. Aqua is a healthcare worker and is really tired of the stupid bastards who think this thing is fake. Terra is a stupid bastard who thought this thing was fake until he got it himself and it kept him in bed for weeks. Now he's earnestly making social media posts describing his experience and urging people not to be like him. Ventus is very upset because his first day of second grade was virtual and he has trouble focusing when learning from home. Master Xehanort thinks the pandemic is a good thing because humanity is the true virus and the population needs thinning, makes an edgy Facebook post about his ideas on it and gets very few likes and very many heated comments about it. Maleficent is the same as Xehanort except her feelings on it have nothing to do with her own personal philosophy, she's just rooting for it because it might pave the way for a less competitive market for some real estate that she's interested in. Pete records a vertical video of himself entering a grocery store without a mask, gets belligerent with a minimum wage worker, stumbles through quoting a made-up legal statute, and still uploads the video, even though it conspicuously cuts off when the manager says he's calling the police. Mulan. Nope, we're not doing that. Rabbit already compulsively washed his hands before this whole thing started, so he's honestly thriving during all of this. Hades protested outside the Colosseum gates because he really wanted to get a haircut. Naminé and Demix were almost certain that all of this isolation and downtime would create an opportunity to work on their art, but still procrastinate and have creative block and beat themselves up over it. Larxene makes social media posts deriding people who went to Halloween parties before promptly totally going to a Halloween party as a witch. Luxord, but actually Luxord, wears a mask but doesn't really make an effort to reduce his traveling or leaving the house. If he gets it, he gets it. It's a gamble he's willing to take. Zexion is doing his best to develop a vaccine. Vexen is also doing that, but he's definitely trying to figure out how he can get rich off of it. Xemnas doesn't care if he gets it because nothing matters. Syax is constantly hate-reading posts from Facebook friends who think the virus is a government conspiracy, knows he should stop because it just makes him mad and puts him in a bad mood, but he can't help it. Zigbar is not so secretly hoping things get worse just to see what happens next. Lexius doesn't really have any opinions about any of this one way or another. Zaldin is the same except with mutton chops. Sneezy is not a popular guy these days. Happy has trouble reading the room. Pence, Fred, and regular Pat act like they're pulling their weight by not going out or engaging in social activities even though they definitely had no plans and basically nothing about their lives has changed because of this. Snow White, Aurora, and Ariel recorded themselves in their castles and palaces singing Imagine, uploaded it to the internet, and 8 months later still don't understand the backlash and how it could be interpreted as tone-deaf. Alice, Jasmine, Cinderella, and Belle actually used their platforms and resources to educate their followers and made financial contributions. Horace really, really misses going to fruit ball games. Titus and Waka throw frat parties, genuinely confused when campus shuts down halfway through the semester. Selfie works part-time as a server at Buffalo Wild Wings, takes great pleasure in denying service to anti-mask patrons, describes it as her favorite part of the job. Roxas really misses his friends, but still follows all the rules, regularly schedules FaceTimes with his buds, keeps the group together. Axel constantly talks about all the cool shit he and his friends are gonna do once everything is back to normal. Xion died young, and it was very sad. Tigger loved the Tiger King phase of quarantine, and Pluto is a good boy who's doing his best, has no idea what's going on, and we all envy him for it. Hey, thanks for watching this stupid video. I just decided to do it today. So it's just a side thing. I said I was doing my KH1 boss ranking video. I am working on that. There might be another thing that comes out in between that, more related to Melody of Memory, because I still am really more so into that right now. So there might be another Melody of Memory video coming out. But yes, boss ranking's coming up. If you enjoyed this, you know, hit like, hit subscribe, leave a comment. Yeah, what group do you fall into? I hope you're not in that regular pack group. That one sucks. So, alright, thanks for watching. Take it easy, and I'll see you next time. I just realized I forgot Marluxia. I don't know, he's washing his hair. He's filming a shampoo commercial. I don't know. He's not that interesting of a guy. He likes flowers. I don't know how to tie that into COVID.